When we think of exercise, most of us picture running, lifting weights, or a fitness class. And while these are all great for physical health, there's another category of movement that's uniquely beneficial for mental health: mindfulness-based practices like yoga and Tai Chi. I'm Dr. Tracey Marks, a psychiatrist dedicated to helping you strengthen your mind, fortify your brain, and build resilience. Today, we'll discuss the science behind these practices, their impact on your mental resilience, and how you can start incorporating them into your life, even if you've never tried them before. Yoga and Tai Chi are often described as mind-body practices because they require your mind and body to work together in harmony. But what does this really mean? Both practices have roots in ancient traditions, yoga from India and Tai Chi from China. Despite their differences, they share one critical element: mindfulness. While practicing yoga or Tai Chi, you're encouraged to focus on your breath, the sensations in your body, and the flow of your movements. This focus is what makes them different from traditional exercise. For example, you might zone out while running or doing repetitive exercises, but with yoga and Tai Chi, you're intentionally tuned in to what's happening in your body at the moment. Two key concepts help explain why these practices are so effective: interoception and embodiment. I'll explain them. Interoception is your ability to sense internal body states, like noticing your heart beating faster when you're nervous or feeling tension in your shoulders after a long day. Developing this awareness can help you recognize early signs of stress and respond to it before it escalates. Embodiment is about feeling fully connected to your physical self. Many of us spend so much time in our heads that we lose touch with our bodies. Practices like yoga and Tai Chi help bring you back into balance, which can improve how you handle stress and regulate your emotions. Now, you might wonder, how do these practices of yoga and Tai Chi actually affect my brain? I'm glad you asked. These movements actually impact how different parts of your brain work together. For example, research on Tai Chi has shown that it can increase connectivity between brain regions involved in managing emotions and making decisions. One study found that during a standing meditation practice in Tai Chi, the left side of the brain's prefrontal cortex became more connected to other key regions like the right prefrontal cortex and the premotor cortex. Your prefrontal cortex helps with focus and decision making, and your premotor cortex helps coordinate your movements. What does this mean for you? By practicing mindfulness-based movement, you're strengthening the parts of your brain that help you stay calm under pressure and make thoughtful choices and manage your emotions more effectively. These changes could be why practices like Tai Chi and yoga are so helpful for reducing stress and improving mental well-being. Now that we understand how these practices work, let's look at their benefits. First is regulating the autonomic nervous system. When you're stressed, your autonomic nervous system activates the fight or flight response. This increases your heart rate, tightens your muscles, and floods your body with stress hormones like cortisol. In practices like yoga and Tai Chi, slow breathing and mindful movement help activate the vagus nerve, a critical component in the parasympathetic nervous system. And over time, this makes you less reactive to stress and more resilient in high-pressure situations. For example, imagine coming home after a stressful day. A quick Tai Chi session can help you feel more calm and centered, allowing you to enjoy your evening rather than carrying the stress with you. Second is improving emotional balance. Studies have shown that these practices can reduce symptoms of anxiety and depression. One reason for this is their ability to improve emotional regulation. When you practice mindfulness, you strengthen your brain's prefrontal cortex, which helps you manage emotions and make thoughtful decisions and stay focused. At the same time, it calms your amygdala, your brain's fear center, which reduces feelings of overwhelm. Regular practice can make it easier to navigate emotionally charged situations like resolving a conflict at work or calming yourself before a big presentation. And then another benefit of this mind-body practice is releasing trauma stored in your body. Stress and trauma aren't just mental experiences. They can get stuck in your body. And this is why you might feel tension in your neck, back, or chest long after a stressful event has passed. Yoga and Tai Chi encourage gentle movements that can help release this stored tension. Trauma-informed yoga focuses on creating a safe, choice-driven environment where you can reconnect with your body at your own pace, supporting gradual healing. Not all yoga classes are designed with trauma sensitivity in mind, so it's important to look for instructors or programs explicitly labeled as trauma-informed. Also, if you're dealing with significant trauma, consider working with a trauma-informed therapist for additional support. If you've never tried yoga or Tai Chi before, it might feel overwhelming at first, but starting small can make it manageable. First, choose the right practice. Yoga involves poses, stretching, and deep breathing. Styles like hatha or yin yoga are great for beginners and because they're slower paced. Tai Chi involves a sequence of flowing movements and sometimes is called meditation in motion. And it's an excellent choice if you prefer movement over static poses. Once you choose your practice, start with short sessions, like just 5 to 10 minutes. Focus on your breath and how your body feels during the practice rather than trying to be perfect with every movement. Use free online resources or beginner classes to learn the basics. For example, Nike has a free training app called the Nike Training Club. You can access over 200 free workouts for strength, endurance, and mobility, including yoga. They don't have Tai Chi on the app, though, but the Tai Chi Foundation has both free and paid online classes. You also want to create a comfortable environment for whatever exercise you choose. Choose a quiet space where you won't be interrupted. Wear comfortable clothing, and for yoga, use a mat or a soft surface. Now, there are different ways that you can apply these practices. For stress relief, focus on slow, rhythmic movements synchronized with deep breathing. Yin yoga or gentle Tai Chi can be good for this. For anxiety, practices that emphasize grounding and present movement awareness, like mindful walking or standing yoga poses, can help calm an anxious mind. For depression, more active forms of yoga or flowing Tai Chi sequences can help boost energy and mood. For trauma recovery, it may be helpful to use trauma-sensitive yoga approaches, which emphasize choice and body awareness without touch. And then for improved focus, practices that involve holding poses or maintaining specific forms for extended periods can enhance concentration and attention. If you don't know how to implement these suggestions, find a qualified instructor who can show you what to do. There are lots of online resources for yoga and Tai Chi. Nike and the Tai Chi Foundation are only two of many options. The key to long-term benefits is consistency, not intensity. And here's how to build a sustainable practice. Schedule it. Add yoga or Tai Chi to your routine at a time that works for you. Morning sessions can set a calming tone for the day, while evening sessions help you unwind. 2, set realistic goals. Instead of aiming for an hour-long session, start with 10 minutes a day. Gradually increase as it becomes a habit. 3rd point, you may have to overcome some barriers. If you lack time, break sessions into smaller chunks throughout the day. If you have low motivation, remind yourself of how good you feel afterwards, or pair the practice with something enjoyable, like listening to calming music. Celebrating your progress helps you stay motivated. Keep a journal to track your changes in mood, stress levels, and overall well-being. And here's the last point for today. Integrating mindfulness-based movement with other practices can take this mind-body movement approach to the next level. And here are 3 ways to create a holistic approach. 1, combine with traditional meditation. Use your movement practice as a lead-in to seated meditation or alternate days of movement and stillness practices. 2nd thing, pair with journaling. After your movement practice, spend a few minutes writing about your experience, insights, or emotions that arose during the session. For example, after a yoga session, journaling about your physical sensations or emotional responses can help reinforce the mind-body connection. And the 3rd suggestion is to incorporate breath work. Many mindfulness-based movement practices already include breath work, but you can deepen this by exploring techniques that are specific to yogic breathing practices. For example, Diaphragmatic breathing involves deep breathing into the belly, which can help calm the nervous system and improve your focus. By incorporating mindfulness-based movement practices into your life, you're not just exercising your body, you're training your mind to be more resilient, balanced, and aware. This is a holistic approach to movement, which can be a powerful tool in your mental health toolkit, complementing other strategies that we've discussed in this series. In our next video, we'll be shifting gears to explore how chronic stress changes your brain chemistry and what you can do about it. Until then, I encourage you to explore some mindful movement and see how it impacts your mental state. Thanks for watching today. I'll see you in the next video.